Hi everyone, it's John Bertles of Bash the Trash, back again to show you another cool and weird musical instrument. Don't forget to check our website at www.bashthetrash.com for more ideas and to see what we do. Today we're going to be looking at tube drums. Now, you do need to have a couple of pretty gnarly tubes for this. As you can see, I've got some gnarly tubes right here. And you need two balloons, and you need some duct tape, and you need scissors. In this particular instrument, what we're doing is we're creating a vibrating membrane, two membranes, so we're actually going to create balloon bongos. I cut off the valve of the balloon like that, and this is going to make the membrane part. This makes a great instrument all by itself, and this I'll save for another episode. Basically, all you do is stretch it over the top like this, so it's stretched down kind of tight. And then I'm going to take some preset duct tape, which I have over here, and I'm just going to go around and sort of hold that into place. Otherwise, the balloon does tend to slip up. And the other one is one that's a deeper pitch. And you can affect it by making it tighter, but you can also affect it by the length of the tube as well. And those two things in combination are the things that really will affect the pitch. So I'm going to cut the valve off the balloon on this one, like so. Open it up and slide it over the top again. And this time what I want to do is I want to check the tension to make sure that the sound is considerably lower, as you can see there. So that's what I'm looking for.
Play some garbage.
Is to put together the two pieces using duct tape again. Now, the mistake that I see a lot of kids making is playing the drums like this because they're all closed off at the bottom. When they're closed off at the bottom like that, none of the air pressure changes are getting out from there. So you really need to put them up at the top like this. Go with the bongos.